I'm here to speak of necessity and roadmap to better batteries. In fact, the energy availability is in a moving and clean world is essential. Energy storage plays a key role for this, and we see it in all domains of application. In portable applications, for instance, every new generation of communication tool needs more energy, and they need batteries for being transportable. More electric vehicles for a cleaner world will be at least the partial solution for progressive mean to overcome the scarcity of oil and at the same time to decrease CO2 emissions or particles, which is a really societal demand. The same is for energy storage. For energy storage, we see that in the network integration, we'll need batteries, we'll need storage, not only batteries, but we'll need storage for in a world where you have too many renewable energy. This is an old diagram which shows the position of batteries in the case of storage, but it is still extremely valid. It was published by the Commission 10 years ago. You see battery in three domains: small transportation, meaning computers, for instance, or tablets, phones, and afterwards you have here, you have batteries for power storage, for instance, hybrid vehicle, and you have here energy batteries for the storage in the grid. Why I am here? My company is making advanced batteries for new application and is a world leader in the most advanced parts of it. We are making lithium batteries for satellites, for planes, for trains, for transportation system, for medical application. So this is the reason why I was asked to comment on the development of batteries. So I will present you now the present choice, then the three steps of the roadmap for the six next years, and the challenge to 250 watt hour per kilogram, and what can happen beyond lithium ion. First of all, batteries for electric vehicles. Batteries are designed for four levels of applications and specification. For stop and start application, of course, you have improved lead-acid batteries with possibly supercapacitors and a little bit of lithium-ion. But the usable energy is low, lower than 500 watt-hour. Second step is hybrid vehicles with the emblematic Toyota Prius, which used nickel metal hydride batteries. But all the more recent hybrid cars use lithium-ion technology. The available energy is around 1.5 kilowatt-hour. Small battery, but very high power. Then you have the plug-in, which is something with higher energy and less power, and the pure electric vehicle, which contains 20 kilowatt-hour minimum, but for bigger cars, 30 or more are preferred. And all plug-in and pure electric use lithium-ion technology. Some examples. The first one, which was operated in Europe, the Mercedes S400 with soft lithium ion battery. This is a typical hybrid. The second is a pure electric, the Nissan Leaf, which has a good battery with 24 kilowatt hour, but of course it is a limited autonomy of 160 kilometers. A new one, which is the Bolloré Blue Car in France. The important innovation of this is not only a technical innovation, but the fact that it is a rental car, Autolib, and in addition, they use lithium metal as negative electrode, and they are alone against all other manufacturers, which prefer for safety issues to use lithium ion. For train, it is also important to mention, you have alkaline battery for more electric train, or more electric trams here. They allow to have an autonomy in pure electric, just for instance, in the city centers. Now, battery for stationary application. Up to now, you know, 90% of batteries for storage application, they used lead acid technology. And the 10% remaining were NiCad for the severe condition application, such as high temperature, oil and gas, or nuclear power. The new application for smart grids association with renewable energies, they are lithium ion oriented because of long life, absence of maintenance, high power for frequency control, they are determining qualities. I don't think that batteries will be used in all systems and will be the only system available. Batteries, in fact, they will be used for high power needs and specific application in insulated parts or just in residential or critical situations such as hospital, for instance. What we propose now is to have such system. And the biggest one, now, several battery manufacturers, they propose batteries in containers to be transported in the places where you need them. There are 20 feet standard containers which can be transported on trucks for alimentation in case of energy problems or for residential application or for help to frequency regulation in the case of wind turbines. Why lithium ion? Lithium ion are all the blue ones. In fact, lithium ion has a great advantage. It can be used for high energy system but also for very high power applications. It envelops all the former batteries which had less energy. You see the lead acid here, which was very poor energy. You have energy here and power of the system here. It's what we call a Ragone plot. Nickel metal hydride are in the middle, not so bad. You can have a relatively good power with them, but lithium ion is better in all circumstances. Typically, here, you have a typical battery for an electric vehicle car. Here, you have something for the plug-in, you have something for the hybrid, and you have the very high-end power, which are for more specific, I would say, military applications. Lithium ion is also extremely interesting because it is versatile with many sub-technologies, and everything in this sub-technology, it is based on innovation in materials. Now, let's go to the strengths and the weaknesses. Of course, we draw our best from the strengths and we try to improve the weaknesses. The first rank, of course, is the best specific energy of the system, the good volumetric energy, the excellent cyclability with respect to all other technologies, the good calendar life, at least if you don't put them at 200 centigrade, the very high power possible, which is more than supercapacitors in some circumstances, excellent energy efficiency, which is very important for renewables, and numerous subsystems possible. And you must choose your subsystem and adapt for a specification. The weakness, of course, it is a complex system. You need a lot of electronics. The global cost of the technology comes also from materials and electronics and safety issues to solve. Safety issue is linked to the fact that if you have more energy in the same box, of course, if the energy escape, it will be more dangerous than the lead acid battery. But we have many work running and many solutions to improve the safety and to ensure the safety at the battery level. Now, the roadmap. The express need of our customer, the guideline for the roadmap, it is clear that we need higher energy, higher specific energy and energy density for pure EV and plug-in. We also need a specific power increase for hybrid vehicle without life decrease. Life is a key issue for all industrial applications, absolutely not for the portable application. We need reliability and safety level at UCAR 4 minimum, which means no flame, no explosion, no flying part, no toxic gas, no parts outside of the container of the battery. And we need also a life, a long life for industrial application, at least 8 years for vehicles, more for standby systems. And we need a cost decrease for all applications. The basis of roadmap for battery improvement, we have 3 steps. At short, mid-term, to draw the best from the lithium-ion technical solutions just for incremental improvement of maybe 15 energy more. To increase energy, drawing the best from the material. It means or specific power available. It means today you have some materials which are not used at 100%. We could use them a bit more. Of course, we need to optimize our choices. We see that there is no universal material. We need to differentiate the material for the application. You will not use the same material for hybrid vehicle or for electric vehicles because of power issues, because of the size of the battery also. We need to simplify and to standardize all the systems for cost reduction and while keeping the same safety. Simplification could be to suppress electronics, but we must think to keep the same safety. In parallel, the second step, to study the feasibility for industrial large batteries or of solutions which are now emerging for the portable cells, but with much shorter life. It's well known that when you have a phone today, you have not more than 200 cycles. It is not possible to use such things for industrial application. So, for the longer term, we need to increase the networking with university on all the breakthrough innovation for the following generation and the after lithium ion. So, 2 to 3 years, I will just give you one example to go on the type of research which is done day after day. Example, which is drawing more positive active material, drawing more from the positive active material. Except on the phosphate material, which is already used 100%, we do not use the full capacity of those materials, because if you go up here, in fact, you decrease the life of the battery due to the reaction of organic electrolyte which is used. But what is done, this has begun to be used for portable cells, but we see perfectly that it reduces a lot the life of the system. So for industrial, we need to do it without reducing the life of the system. And so the solution of voltage increase has begun to be implemented, but for the industrial application, what we do, we protect the surface of the materials with nano coating for interface stabilization. We reinforce safety by other methods, such heat resistant layers on separators, but also we make the necessary research on electrolytes and additives. For the optimization of the system, we do different choices of materials, and we also make mixes of material to combine the positive effect and decrease the drawback. So it's a trade-off to find for power, life, cost, safety, all parameters having not the same importance for the different applications. So within the next 3 years, we expect to have an improvement of something like 20% with the same value of price decrease per kilowatt hour, which will come from a better use of material, process, and scale up. For battery management simplification, we are doing especially the knowledge of the aging in order to have a better dimensioning of the system. Today, sometimes we over-dimension and it is a loss of materials. The step beyond, the availability of new materials are a key issue for this step. The nature of material and type of reaction which determine the theoretical capacity, and afterwards the organization in terms of size, nano or not, conductive additives, coating, blends, no critical source, as it was mentioned before by the two former presenters. So it helps to go towards the theoretical capacity. Theoretical capacity, of course, is the objective, but the way to reach it is all this. We also know that the gain on one polarity becomes marginal when the other polarity has a capacity 4-5 times higher. So it means that we need to work at the same time on both sides, positive and negative electrode sides. Today, the most advanced family to progress toward the target of 250 water per kilogram, negative material based on silicon and tin, and NMC lithium rich for positive active materials, though you can have safety issues here. Yes. The choice of material that you can have today, the material which are used is graphite and some of those materials here. For the negative electrode, we have a choice of materials which can have 10 times the capacity for silicon. In fact, we try to use silicon, but at a lower value of its capacity to be able to increase life. Because the problem of silicon is the fact that you have a huge volume increase when you use it, and the volume is more or less proportional of the to the capacity you have. So you must refrain the idea to use the total capacity and use only maybe 1,000 milliampere per gram. And the challenge is also to contain the volume expansion using nanosized particle and electrode structuration, silicon composites or nanotubes with silicon around. We hope to increase the life. There are many, many teams working on this topic around the world, which has in itself more than 30 to 50 patents per day. I'm almost finished, yes. So the swelling is the problem. I will skip this. And the solution envisaged, I have commented already, so I will not. On the positive side, you have several possibilities, new high capacity and other families of polyanions compounds, which should be interesting if voltage is sufficient and if we have the possibility to have nanomaterials here. Beyond lithium ion, you have lithium air, 1,000 watt-hour per kilogram, lithium sulfur, low-cost lithium sodium batteries, the use of bio-renewable materials, very open possible solutions. I have just one example on sodium sulfur. Sodium sulfur, the advantage is low-cost, high capacity, but we have today a lot of limitations and problems. You have numerous projects running. It is the most advanced of the long term with small industrial companies. A task force in the European network Alistor, but what we can say is the research step is not finished. It is something for really the end of 2020. Conclusion. Batteries, they are key enabling technologies and they are on a critical path of many innovations. Materials are the core of battery. A substantial part of the results on material has been obtained in the frame of cooperation between materials manufacturers, battery manufacturers, and often support of European Commission in many cases. And as everybody, we have our valley of death, which is the long duration of qualification. When you need 2,000 cycles, it is long to do, and the ways to reduce is sometimes not possible. And also the cost of demonstrator, especially for stationary application. Thank you for your attention.